Hi everyone. Did you know you can tweak your charts with VBA? For example, you can dynamically adjust the data source or set the chart's axis. Today, we'll be using VBA to make our charts interactive. As we scroll, our chart will update automatically. Let's get started. To observe how VBA can dynamically modify the data range of a chart, press Alt F11 to open VBA Editor. Insert a new module and create a subroutine called Update Chart. Inside this subroutine, insert the code shown on the screen. The sheet1.chartobjects identifies the chart object named chart1 on the worksheet. The chart object represents a collection of all the chart objects on that worksheet, and chart1 specifies the particular chart object within that collection. The .chart is used to access the chart itself. This allows us to perform actions and access properties related to the chart. SetSourceData source code assigns the data range for the chart, and sheet1.range specifies the range of cells from A1 to E5 on sheet1 as the data source for the chart. Make sure to replace the chart name with the actual name of your chart object. If you're unsure, click on the chart, and you'll find its name in the name box at the top left of the worksheet. You can also rename it as per your preference. Now, to see the magic happen, set a new source data range with fewer rows. Then, click inside the subroutine and press F5 to execute the code. Open your Excel sheet, and you'll notice the chart dynamically adjusting its data range as per your VBA instructions. Each time you adjust the chart's data range in the VBA editor, these changes will be immediately reflected on the chart when the subroutine is executed. In next step, we'll integrate a scroll bar beneath the chart. This scroll bar will empower users to dynamically modify the cell range associated with the chart as they interact with it. To add the scroll bar, go to the Developer tab. If it's not visible, click on the File tab, choose Options, then Customize Ribbon. Check the Developer tab in the list, then click OK. The Developer tab should now appear on your ribbon. Now, go to Developer tab, click on Insert, and then choose Scroll Bar under the Form Control section. Draw the scroll bar below the chart on the worksheet. Right-click on the scroll bar and choose Format Control. The Format Control dialog box will appear. The current value refers to the current position of the scroll bar within its defined range. For example, if the scroll bar has a minimum value of 1 and a maximum value of 100, its current value could be anywhere between 1 and 100, indicating its relative position within that range. In VBA, we will access this value to dynamically adjust the data range of a chart. This means that as we move the scroll bar, the chart's data range will automatically update based on the scroll bar's value. We'll input 2 in the minimum value box and 13 in the maximum value box as our chart's data begins from row 2 and ends at row 13. We also can modify these values through VBA when accessing the value of the scroll bar. To access a scroll bar in VBA, you must know its name. Simply click on it, and you'll find its name displayed in the name box. Let's set the minimum and maximum values of the scroll bar dynamically through VBA. The code sheet1.shapes identifies the scroll bar object named scrollbar2 on the worksheet named sheet1. The shapes object represents the collection of all shape objects on a worksheet, including scroll bars, images, etc. The control format property returns a control format object, which contains properties and methods specific to form controls that we saw when right-clicking the scroll bar and choosing format control. The min property indicates the minimum value for the scroll bar. We assign 2 to it to match it with the first row number of our table. The max property indicates the maximum value for the scroll bar. We assign 13 to it to match it with the last row number of our table. Next, we'll declare a variable named scroll value to store the current position of the scroll bar. To streamline our code and avoid repetitive object naming, we'll utilize the with statement. The with statement allows us to perform multiple actions on the same object without repeatedly specifying its name. It's particularly useful when we need to access properties or methods of a single object several times within a block of code. Within the with statement, we'll simply write .value to assign the current value of the scroll bar to the scroll value variable. This eliminates the need for a lengthy code line and ensures code readability. To test our code, we'll create a message box and write the scroll value variable to display the current value of the scroll bar. Press F5 to run the subroutine. Excel will display a message box showing 2. Now, click the scroll bar arrows to change its position, then run the subroutine again. Excel will display the new current value of the scroll bar. To automate the execution of the subroutine when we interact with the scroll bar, right-click on the scroll bar and click Assign Macro, then choose Update Chart. Now, whenever we use the scroll bar, the subroutine will automatically execute, and Excel will show the current value of the scroll bar in the message box. This method creates a custom scroll bar event, so whenever the scroll bar changes its position, the VBA code responds accordingly. Go back to the editor, remove the message box, and relocate the code that changes the chart's data source after the scroll bar code chunk. This adjustment allows us to manipulate the scroll value variable to create a new data range for the chart. Next, declare a new variable named chart range to hold the updated chart range based on the scroll bar value. Assign chart range variable a range as shown on the screen. The and sign concatenates the letter A with the value of the scroll value variable, and then concatenates E with the same value. This creates a range starting from column A and ending at column E, with the row number determined by scroll value. Finally, assign the chart range variable to the setSourceData method. Now, whenever we use the scroll bar, the subroutine runs. It retrieves the current value of the scroll bar, manipulates it to create a new dynamic data range, and assigns it to the chart. This entire process creates a dynamic chart that changes its source based on the scroll bar position. Notice that the chart is displaying numerical values instead of category labels on the x-axis, indicating that Excel is interpreting your data as numerical rather than categorical. To address this issue, insert a new code line to update the chart's axis. First, we modify the code line that adjusts the chart's data range to use the with statement. This streamlines our code and prevents repetition. Next, we add a new line of code. The axis object represents all the axes in the chart, and XL category is a constant for the category axis. The category names property sets the labels for the categories on this axis, which appear as the labels on the x-axis of your chart. The new line of code sets the category labels for the chart's category axis to the values in cells A1 to E1 on sheet 1. This allows you to dynamically specify the category labels based on the data in your worksheet. Close the VBA editor and use the scroll bar. You will see that the numbers on the category axis are now replaced with the headings from the data table. Hope you enjoy this video. I've explained how to change a chart's source data and category axis using VBA. I also covered how to insert a form control scroll bar and assign it a macro. Each time you use the scroll bar, it triggers a subroutine that gets the scroll bar value, manipulates it, and creates a new chart range based on that value. This process results in a dynamic chart that updates as you scroll. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below.